Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitcher, a retired lecturer in Methodology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to give my experience of visit to Cluj in Romania when I attended an International Ecumenical Forum or Fellowship Conference from 27 July to 3rd August, in which there were singing songs and other things, praises, and there were visits to some monasteries. So there are quite a few monasteries in the Cluj, Hungary area, and in Cluj most of the educated people are the people who had professors and other things. They were Hungarian, and so there's a quite a good sharp distinction between Romanian and Hungarian. Of course, there were gypsies whose color was as black as we Indians are, and they moved from India long years ago. However, as I explained in my previous video, how the people were being blind faith, they were showing at the monasteries and devoting their time in prayers and other things. So these clerics, you know, when I opposed them and exposed them, that they are antichrist who are standing between man and God, because between man and God no person can stand. Only we have to render exposition of his word, which is the mediator between man and God. Remember, in rabbinic system, the rabbi is sitting in a temple made by human hand of brick and mortar. So the person sitting there is also a human. But this is the age of Christ. So in Christ, you know, this we have God, which is not made by human hand, but by nature. So the person
who is sitting inside your heart is Christ. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot preach Christianity. So one of the lady over there was chairman of this conference. She is British. She had written some books, and she was probably presenting to people who have done something that this book is signed by the Archbishop of Canterbury. She will stress that one every time he presents that book to anyone. So Archbishop of Canterbury, Church of England, is headed by Queen, not headed by God or by Christ Jesus. So it's a church of mammon, nothing to do with God. In mammon, you have to be sweet-spoken. You can't be harsh to people. However, people complain to her, you know, this man from Britain, you know, is too much rough, you know, and we don't like him. So she told me that, oh, Mr. Nitcher, there are so many complaints against you. So please don't come to our meeting next time. And she asked me if I were a Christian. I said, no, I'm not a Christian. Then she said, what are you then, if you are not Christian? What do you do here in our conferences? I said, I preach Christianity and I believe in Jesus, but I'm not a Christian, but a Christ with small c. Now, these people don't have any idea what Christ stands for. So she must have taken that word to the other people and told them, this man is a heretic. He's calling himself a Christ. So you can see how fool they were making of me when I disclosed that I have Christ in my heart, or I am a Christ with small c. Now, Jesus, who had Christ with capital C, that's why he told his workers or laborers, they were not disciples, that Don't tell anyone that I am Christ. Keep it to yourself. So that's why he said so, because to prevent or to make yourself a laughing stock among the fools, they will just laugh at you. So that's what happened over there to me. And so they told me not to come anymore onto these conferences. Said I'm quite happy not to come, because you are not productive. You know, they're just sitting there. People are being fleeced, robbed, and other thing, and you have no sense to recognize it, identify the thing, what's happening. But they were just having self-centered praises. That is the idea of the psychic. Psychic never annoy anyone, as the politicians, they always like to have support of the public. So they had the support, but I have none of those support but of my father. So I didn't bother, I didn't care. So same way, there was a man over there who had done his degree in theology, and he just got his job as a pastor. And he happened to ask questions to me, and I answered to him, and I explained to him the five husbands of this Samaritan woman and other details. In a house there are five, three against two, and two against the three. And I explained all those things to him. And also, I wanted to explain to him the parable of marriage and divorce, Matthew 19. But he was not that keen to know it, so he did not want to see me again, because other people have told him, you know, this man you are talking, he is a heretic. And they, I think, spoke a lot of bad things to me. And they told me, he told me one day, came to visit me, that, oh, Mr. Niger, there are many people speaking against you, and they are calling you all sort of names and other things. I said, okay, tell me what those are calling me. He said, oh, I can't tell you, you know, they are so bad, you know, things they are saying against you. I said, that's what they are supposed to say, you know, because they don't know. But he was became, you know, when he had people, other people give the opinion, he was became of doubting type. And I have explained to him that John the Baptist baptized men in water only in the name of Abraham, which he seemed to have understood, and he was stressing, "Yes, I know this one very well." And then I told him Christ Jesus was baptized in the name of anointed second Adam. That's why John the Baptist said, "I am not even allowed to touch your shoes, you know, laces," because he was working for the first Adam. And here come the anointed second Adam, the greatest of all. So that's why he was not able to, saying that I can't touch your shoes even. So he baptized him in the name of second anointed Adam. And Holy Spirit spoke in the air, "This is my son, listen to him." That was the purpose or the moral of baptism, to make people sons of man or sons of their own father. So the Holy Spirit said that he is our son, begotten son. So listen to him. So the trip on the whole was quite a good experience, and I stayed 6 days. I went earlier, 21st July to 6th of August, early 6th August I left. And there's an airline which is called Wizz Air, which is cheap, that goes from Luton, and you can go to Cluj for £50 or so return. So it's quite a good deal, you know, flight. So if chance be became, I might go again. God bless you.